Chris said you were allowed to tell any secrets you wanted.
Oh, okay. Well,
you said you're gonna tell us all. Tell
us all.
You like it?
Yeah.
Well, as I've gotten older, I tend to say a lot more things.
That's okay.
That's a good thing.
So what's been the biggest surprise about coming back to the world of the X-Files after a long hiatus?
It was just like a year, maybe the last six. It just always feels like I'm coming back home. The scripts are always, they're always a surprise. They're always great. They're always like we used to describe them as getting Christmas presents. You know, it's like you open them up, it's like opening up a Christmas present and seeing what they had in store for your character, your storyline. But it's always fun to come back and play these characters and work with these, you know, these other actors and work with Chris and the other people that we work with on the show. So it's pretty awesome. It's a gift to keep getting, man. 25 years later, here we are. I got no complaints. It's wonderful.
One thing I've always loved about Skinner is I felt he always, and his action showed it, that in a lot of ways he believed in Scully and Mulder and really looked out for them. And I thought that almost made it like a triad rather than just a two of them.
Well, he's their support. He's their champion within the FBI. I think that they were looking for somebody to fill that role, and unfortunately, I just happened to fall into it. So I feel blessed.
What about a Skinner spinoff? You and Chris ever talk about just focusing the show just on you?
Yeah, you know what? When they spun the long gun went off, I went to Chris and I'd go, "What the hell is going on? They're spinning them off? What about Skinner? Why don't they spin Skinner off?" And he goes, he looked at me and he goes, "What would it be about?" And I was like, I have no idea. I mean, what would it be about? So it was, I don't know. I don't know if that's anything that was, unless it was Cigarette Smoking Man and Skinner like going at each other, you know, spinning the two of those characters off until they just beat each other to death or whatever. But there is a Skinner centric episode coming up, so I'm very excited about it. Written by Gabe Rotter, who's one of Chris's longtime associates.
The passage of time is obviously a big factor in the changes to all these characters, but I was wondering if there was anything...
How do I look so good?
No, not at all. Don't take that out of context. That's not what I meant. What I wanted to get to was there anything else that you had in mind or that you talked about with the writers wanting to bring to Skinner now?
No.
That you
come up with the show? No, you know what? I'm not a writer. I'm not a story guy. Too lazy. I tried writing, and it was painful. And somebody read what I wrote, and they were like... I thought all the dialogue that I written was brilliant. It was like, they go, yeah, okay, where's it going? I was like, I have no idea. But so I don't, unless there's something in the course of doing a scene, like just the other day I was shooting the scene with David, and there was a line in it that just didn't ring true for me, for the character. So I said, I just don't think I was thinking that I would say this line. And he was like, okay. They're very good about that.
So. They didn't encourage that, like whenever it really.
Well, I don't know if it's necessarily encouraged. Yeah. It's like, but they definitely do listen to our point of view and our opinions. Respect to that.
Skinner is such a serious character, and I've recently watched you in a couple of great roles like Shocker and 3 o'clock High, which was a lot of fun to see you in, where you get to be a little more fun. Is it challenging to kind of slip into that? You know,
I found myself the other day. Because, yeah, I mean, I've done other things where I played a character on Dallas and I was like a rogue, and he was like, he took joy in being a dick, you know, and I found myself wanting to maybe bring a little bit of that to Skinner just to open up, make it more dimensional or something like that, and I just couldn't do it. It just didn't feel right to me. But I can't. But But he is, yeah. And like I said, you find out how he is.
You did a couple of these sort of like large genre franchises over the years. How has the fandom changed since when you started through the different?
Well, they have a lot more access to us. As a matter of fact, I'm going to a fan-based benefit tonight at Columbia Club for No Kids Hungry, which is a charity that I like to focus on. And I have a really good relationship with these people. They come. I do a lot of conventions, so I meet a lot of these people, and I've become friends with a lot of them. You know? So now it's like. It's a little worrisome in that now they know me, you know, and so when they watch Skinner, they're going, no, that's you know, it doesn't seem true, you know what I mean? Does that make sense? So that's a little, and being active on social media is a lot now too, because it's for the people that are going to be familiar with who I am, so that when they watch the role that I'm playing, it just doesn't, you know, it doesn't sit well. I've talked to other actors about that, and they're going, yeah, that's true too, but then they're going, you know, you can do a lot of really cool things on social media as far as advancing charities and trying to help people out who need help.
So with this Skinner-centric episode, we're going to see the dynamics change between Skinner and Scully and Vulva.
You're going to see dynamics change between the three of them before that. That's all I'm going to say. Sorry.
What did it feel like to go from acting director to director? I mean, for years it was acting director.
No, assistant director. He's still assistant director.
Assistant?
Yeah, no. I think in the comics they made him a... I think he got some kind of promotion, deputy director, I think, or something like that. But yeah, that's the comic books. Mm-hmm. And on the show, he's still an assistant director, and you know, you find out why he is this season. Yeah. Which I'm happy about.
Outside of Skinner, because you've played so many different kinds of roles in your career, is there what attracts you to a role nowadays? Or is there a certain kind of role you're still looking to play?
I just want it, you know, as long as, I mean, I know that actors say this a lot, but as long as the writing's good, as long as the story's good, blah, blah, blah. But it's actually true. I'm kind of cutting back on doing guest starring roles on TV because I've done them all. I don't want to do them anymore. You know, I mean, if there's a great recurring role or a series regular, I would do series in it. But I just don't want to do a bunch. And for a long time there, I was doing guest star after guest star, and some of them were not good. You know, I was fortunate enough to work on Criminal Minds and do an episode, play a character that I was very proud of. So if something like that would have materialized, then. You know, I would love to do that, but I didn't even know what that was going to be when I got it, because somebody had dropped out. The director called me up and asked me if I would take the role over, and it turned out to be one of the things that I'm most proud of as far as acting in TV. Any other lies you want me to tell you?
I think what I enjoyed last year was the episode where you kind of told the story of the X-Files and the monsters. I thought that was one of the most... I'm surprised they hadn't done it before.
That's Darren Morgan.
Yeah, that was fantastic.
That's Darren Morgan. That's what he does. You know, he does some really, really interesting stuff. And he's and I'm finally... got into a Darren Morgan episode. I've been lobbying them for so long, book the Morgans, to put me in their episodes, and it's like the last six they weren't able to because they were trying to have so much story to tell, and Skinner didn't fit into the story. But this time, I got to work with both of them, so it was great.
Do you personally have a preference between the mythology-based episodes or the more Monster of the Week episodes?
Well, I like them all. Yeah. I mean, the mythology are the ones that Skinner is usually part of, but I have to be honest, the episodes that are my favorites are episodes that I'm not in. And I don't know if that's a common thing with actors or not, but it's like, I get distracted by me being there and watching the performance or whatever, but I just like watching the show and not having to worry about that aspect. But I am a fan of the show. I think it's a great show. It's the fact that we're doing it, still doing it almost 25 years later, is pretty, pretty awesome. It's awesome. I feel blasted. It's like the gift that keeps giving.
So we saw younger versions of Mulder and Scully last year in the two new agents. It's going to be like a different version of like Skinner, like a younger, new Skinner.
I'm not going to answer
that. I'm going to keep asking questions.
Go for it.
You know, when you left X-Files, then you did do another series, another sci-fi genre series with Stargate, which was a lot of fun.
Which was basically Skinner in a flight suit.
Right. But you guys at least get out of the office, yeah, and onto a spaceship, I guess, most of the time.
I did have a spaceship. Right, that's pretty cool.
What was that experience like? Because that's also a very dedicated fan base.
It was fun. You know, I had a spaceship, you know, and it's fun sitting on the bridge, man, doing all that, you know, with the pyro and, you know, barking commands and doing battles in space, you know, it's a trip. And it was a great cast to work with, you know. There was a lot of good actors to work with, and I really had a good time. Plus, it was in Vancouver, and it was a lot of fun.
One of the first films I remember seeing you in was Shocker, way back in the day with Peter Berg, who's gone on to become a very prominent director now. Have you guys thought about possibly collaborating or anything?
I actually saw, I went to, David was doing one of his performances, and he sings, you know, and at the Roxy in Hollywood, and my wife and I went to it, and I looked down and I saw Pete was down, he was, David had invited him, they're friends. And I saw him, and I said to my wife, I said, hey, he's happy bird. So I was sort of walking towards him, and he turns and he looks at me. And as I'm walking towards him, his eyes just keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And I stopped, and I said, do you remember me? And he goes, Mitch? And he goes, I just had visions of terror. Horace Peter was coming to kill me. He said, that's all I saw when you were walking towards me, Horace Peter. But and we exchanged numbers, and I would love to work with Pete again. You know, at the time when we were doing Shocker, it was one of his first things, I think.
Yeah.
And at that time, man, he was like a hawk watching everything that Wes did. And he said to us one day, he came to work one day, and he goes, I'm going to be a big director when he does. And I was like, you know, he called it. I'm very, very happy for him.
It looks like all the different ways that people can access the X-Files on the internet. What is that? I mean, that's so changed from 93, 94. It was
pretty primitive, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, the internet was pretty primitive back then. Some of those chat rooms, and it was like, this is, you think back about those things now. It's weird. I think it's definitely had, I think it's had an effect. I think it's definitely going to have an effect on the story. I think the Chris works, I mean, he likes keeping his fans, you know, he likes listening to them and seeing what they have to say. If it works with the show, but he definitely does pay attention to what the fans are saying. I think you're going to see the result of that this season. So, it's pretty cool stuff this season. I mean, it's like, I keep saying, it's like old school Mulder and Scully. It's like what they, back to what they were doing when they originally doing the show, they made everybody love the show so much. You know? and built such a tremendous fan base that we have, that has stuck with us for so long. And the fact that we have new generations of fans, you know. I go to these conventions, I see, you know, kids 10 years old come up there. I've just watched every episode, you know, and it's like, it's so gratifying to see that type of response. The parents, right, the grandparents have passed it down to the parents. It's actually almost three generations, you know, and those parents have passed it down to their kids. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah.